Hi everybody, Stevie.D Carp Angler here. Just finishing up work and getting ready to set up for a 24 hours out in the bank tomorrow. Venue of choice tomorrow is Idenwood Fisheries. I was actually taught on these set of lakes by my dad before he passed away. I haven't actually fished the lakes for about 15 or 16 years. Don't know why I haven't been back there, but I think now is a good time to go back and see what I can get up on the bank. So had a chat with the owner Andy in regards to bait and tackle restrictions. Most of the tackle is standard stuff. They like barbless hooks, you know, unhooking max cradles, big enough nets, etc. The only thing he doesn't really allow is boilies, so I'm going to keep with my normal hinge stiff rig setup, which I'll show in the video tomorrow. And all I've done is I've substituted in boilies for some pop-up plastic style baits. I've got some different styles of corn, some dumbbells and stuff, which I've all got soaking at the moment in carp junkie liquid attractors, so that'll be good. But I've also been told that surface fishing is really good at the moment as well, and as long as the weather holds tomorrow, I'm going to try and get some of the takes and stuff recorded from surface finishing using bread, dog biscuits, just with a free line hooked on my 6-foot stalking rod. So yeah, let's have a look and see what we can get up on the bank, and hopefully we can get some nice ones for you. Thank you very much. Just got down to Idenwood Fisheries, and so first time I've been here in about 15 or 16 years, so I've just parked up just to take a few short clips of the lakes as I get down to the main specimen lake. So right up here at this point you've got two match lakes. Here's match lake one, just as I remember it, probably a little bit more cut down, a bit more open than it used to be, and it's got another bit just over towards the back. And then it branches off just behind these trees into a second part of the match lake as well. Loads of little swims, loads of good fish in here from what I hear. A few of my friends have had some good sort of mid-20 fish come out of here off the surface over the last couple of weeks as well. So you never know, it might pop up here and have a little look if it gets quiet down in the specimen lake. Let's go down the specimen and see what we got. Right, morning guys. Down here at Idenwood Fisheries, nice and early in the morning. Got down to the specimen lake. I am the only one here, so at the moment I've got the entire lake to myself. So I've just had a good walk around the lake, spent about 20 minutes, half an hour, checking out a few of the open swims. there's only one main island in the middle of the lake, but there's a good few points to get onto that. A lot of overhanging trees, a few light sort of patches of pads and stuff to get onto. I haven't really seen any kind of activity as such in regards to sort of fish showing or whatever. There's a couple of light fizzy bubbles, but nothing really obvious. But if I've got the lake to myself, I've got the option to cast out to a couple of spots that I like. If I don't get anywhere, I've got the option to move around a bit. So yeah, I've taken a few short clips of the swims that I'm looking at as well, so I'll put them in there, and let's see how we get on. Right, quick little update. It's now 9:15, so it's about half an hour since I'd had my walk around. Literally went back to the car to get all my gear out and stuff. I literally just walked just over there from the car park. First swim that I've come across, just looked into it on the rink, and a couple of light fizzing, and then a nice big old crash of some carp jumping out just off the island. So I decided that this was where I was going to pitch up first, so I just quickly hooked up both my rods. Couple little 2-ounce leads on both of them on a leg clip. Hooked up my hinge stiff rigs that I've got my plastic pop-up corn on that I've had soaking in the Carp Junkie TMT liquid attractor. And let's see if anything comes of it. It's nice and early if they're jumping up like that. It's a good time for a bite, I reckon. Let's see what happens. Right. You find me back in my car now. I'm all packed up. I spent a couple of hours on that spot where I cast out showing fish. Didn't get anything. Put a few biscuits out close to the island, saw a few showing fish. The swim soon spooked out, it all dried up. Nothing. Opportunity came to come move around the island, fish the same spot but from a different angle. The baits were all good, the setups were all good. Fish were still fizzing around, there was just nothing. There's also a lot of work going down around on the outskirts of there, where they're cutting down some of the trees, getting ready for the logging season and everything else. Bonfires and stuff going on, so there's a lot of loud noise. It's quite hard to concentrate down there. And just as the day's going on, it's only just starting to warm up now, but it's not going to get too much brighter. And you just get the feeling that it wasn't going to play well. I wasn't really going to get anything out of it. There wasn't a bite there. I've just come up and parked up now on the match lake to have a look around, but it's quite busy down here. There's a couple of local groups that are fishing on here, so the lake's fairly busy as well. So I'm going to do a quick change of venue altogether, and I'm going to make my way over to Chequertree, purely because I know that I'm going to go down there. If I can get in one or two of the spots that I like to fish in quite regularly, I'm going to be getting to a good head of fish, some nice sized fish, something worth videoing. So yeah, I don't want today to be wasted, so I'm going to head my way over to Chequertree now, and then we'll see how we get on.
I'm so hard to swallow.
Right, down at Chequertree after my move from Iden. I've been here about 45 minutes. I haven't even unpacked any of my kit yet, it's all here. Started fishing off the top. I've had two fish already, sort of between 8 and 9 pounds. And then I've gone and hooked this monster. 19 pounds, 9 ounces. And as always, they don't want to play nice.
bad for fish number three. I think the move to Chequertree from Iden Wood was a good idea, don't you? Go. Oh, wasn't expecting that, wasn't even looking. Stripping line. Today. Didn't take long. Big fish, but it's an exciting take, and I hope it showed up on the camera as well. Little scrappy mirror, putting up a nice little fight, but giving it up pretty quickly. There we go. Get in the net, get in the net. No, seen the net, doesn't want it. No, don't take me in there. Oh, just trying to do a salmon impression. Just bring him in like that, nice and high. Thank you. behind me now. These fish are literally everywhere. There's a little one here just resting on the reeds. Let's drop a bit of bread in front of his face. And he's got it. And he's off. Just like that. And this fish, and one has just come up and snuck a bit of bread from the corner of my net. Come on. Let's have a little walk with him then. I think he's close to my swing. I can gain a bit of line on him. Nothing big, just lively. It's a nice looking common. Nope, still stripping line. Come on. Oh, he's really in close now, actually. You can see him there. Just get his head out of the water. There we go, Mr. Common. Slide you into the net. Yes. Okay. Still surface fishing. Haven't unpacked any of my other gear yet. Just had this 11-pound common. Still off the top. Cracking little spot. He's off. Bowling off again. There it goes. even as I'm playing this fish, just to my left and my right, they're still coming up and grabbing the bread. They're not spooked by anything. Oh, there we go. Oh, it's another nice looking mirror. Possible double. Maybe a little bit smaller than that. But it's still a fire. And it still wants to strip off line. He's in the net. That was a quiet take. Little fish want to go, they go. Come on. The smallest colour I'm going to catch today. Woken up. You're only tiny, come on, give it up.
Still surface fishing, still haven't unpacked any gear, still haven't got my bivvy up, still haven't got my bottom rods out, still haven't baited up, because the fish have been coming off the top so regularly. I've just landed this one, not massive,
but it's a pretty scaly little beauty. So I best show you it. It's probably, I don't know, maximum of about 9 pounds or so. And probably put up a bigger fight than that 19 pounder from earlier. There we go. Beautiful little thing. I still haven't put my bivy up, I still haven't got my bottom rods out, still using bread off the top, and I've just caught this absolute stunner of a mirror, and it went 13 pounds 12 ounces. Right, stumpy little thing, fat old belly on it. Come. I think this is probably going to be the last surface fish I do, because I need to spend some time getting all my other gear ready for the night session ahead. And I think I'm probably just going to put my bottom rods in the margin areas where I've been fishing off the surface. The fish obviously seem to be sitting there, so let's get this one back and get set up for the night.
Hi everybody, right, just a little update. It's about 9:15 now. What an afternoon it has been. I think I've landed sort of 12, 14 fish, up to that 19 pound 9 ouncer that I had pretty much after I first got here. It's just been constant. I've had several other fish that I've just taken photos of, didn't bother sort of taking videos of. And crazily enough, actually, the last hour or so, it's pitch black outside, my bottom rods are everything all out, and they're still taking off the surface. I'm standing out there in the pitch black, casting a bit of bread randomly into the night, and then sort of randomly showing my sort of headlamp over it to it in just the general direction, just so I can make sure I know where it is, and they're still taking it. I can't understand it, really. Again, none of them have been very big, sort of 6-7 pounds, maybe one slightly bigger than that. So I didn't bother getting a camera out or the GoPro camera to take a video of it. The bottom rods have been out. I've had a couple of takes on those. Unfortunately not landed any fish, but they're still rigged up with the pop-up sweet corn that I used at Iden Woods. The rigs are all set up. It seemed silly not to use them. But I've just spent the last sort of 10 minutes tying up and getting ready for some of the Carp Junkie pop-ups. Few stringers for the mesh bags and stuff to go in as well, so I'm going to bring my rods in, cast them out, and then see how the night goes.
Right guys, here we are, night bites have just begun. It's now 10:15 in the evening, and left hand rod is just ripped off. And to be fair, now that I've got it in the old cradle, I actually thought this fish was a hell of a lot bigger the way this thing was fighting. It went to 10.5 pounds. It's a lovely looking mirror. I'm just going to get this open and try and take a short little video. A lean little fighting machine, that thing. So I'm going to take a picture of it, and then I'll get it back in the lake and cast out again. Right, here we are. It's now just gone 1 o'clock in the morning. Another bite. Another nice fight. Pretty cold now though. But this mirror went
12 pounds 4 ounces. Morning. Right, so Tuesday morning, my overnight stay at Chequertree. It was a crazy night. Bites kept on coming. It got to about 3 o'clock in the morning, and it was so cold last night. Frost started setting open, everything else like that. Blah blah blah. So I made the decision to bring my rods in. Once I took the last of the bites off of them and put them into one side, just so I could get a couple of hours sleep. It's now about 7:30, and the weather's completely changed. Yesterday it was bright sunshine, hot as anything. It's now cloudy and it's absolutely chucking it down. The rain is easing off a little bit now, so hopefully I can get a good hour or so's fishing in before I pack up and get home. So let's see what I can get going. Still surface fishing. I've just got this lovely 14 pound angry mirror. Beautiful, clean.
Very angry.
It's a good way to start the morning if you ask me though. Gonna put it back. Right. Last fish of the session. Really must go home now. But I just hooked this lovely little dark beauty. I thought I'd better show you. Pristine looking little thing. Okay. So, what session it turned out to be. Plenty of fish, plenty of takes, mostly surface fishing as always.